Howdy y'all, this is Austin Gridley Pickleball coming at you with another video. Today I want to be talking about where you should be contacting the ball, as well as what to do if you're having to extend or you're just barely getting to the ball, maybe you're having to cover for your partner, whatever it is. So very basics, if you're doing a forehand, you want it just very comfortably just right of your right leg. You don't want it too close, too far away. If I'm going like this, my consistency and power will go significantly down. So I want to take it just here if I can help it. Same with the backhand. I want it just in the middle of my person, but just a little bit to the left. So very comfortably here. This is about where I want it to go. So instead of right in the middle of your belly button, just a little tiny bit to the left. So that's ideally where I want to be taking my forehand and backhand if I can help it. But sometimes we're not able to do that. We're covering for our partner, whatever it is. And so I've struggled with my forehand, especially if I'm just barely getting to the ball, I'm just barely getting there. Something that I worked on today that was really helpful to me was for the forehand, especially, I would, let's say I'm going to get to the ball, I plant my forehand leg, so for a right-handed player, my right leg, and I plant it and I extra push off with it. And it increases your consistency way more. And so I'm here, plant, really push off, and I just focus on that plant on the foot that's for my forehand, right foot, backhand, left foot. Really focus on that plant, makes a huge difference. With the backhand, I have less trouble because I find it easier. Like I have my left hand kind of close to my paddle, and then as I hit it, I open up my chest. And so I'm able to get quite a bit of power from my chest, and so it helps. It helps where the forehand, it's a little bit harder to get that with the chest. This is something that's going to help me a little bit more with my forehand. One more thing for reaching for the ball and staying consistent. Sometimes people, when they're reaching for the ball, they'll kind of cock their wrist back like this, and I think it's because they think it's going to give them more time or something. But I promise you, if you cock your wrist back like that, forehand or backhand, let me come a little closer. So, you cock it back like that, or you cock it back like this, your consistency will drop probably 90% if you do that. So make sure you're not doing that. Keep your wrists up front, and you can move it behind you if you need to, but do not bring your wrist back. Your consistency will drop significantly. Do not do that. Okay, one more thing for positioning of where I want to be hitting the ball. For, let's say I'm doing forehand drops, one of the top three mistakes I make with forehand drops is usually when I'm back there, I open up every time for a forehand drop, open up this way for a backhand drop. Anyways, for forehand drops especially, usually when I mess, one of the top three mistakes I'll make is if it's too close to my body, I kind of get jammed up. I'm not able to get the power I want. It's more of a problem than if I'm reaching too far this way. A little bit reaching out this way is not as big of a deal as if I'm too close to my body. I want to be taking it right here, just comfortably to the side. I do not want to be taking it too much here or here. That's when my consistency drops a fair bit. And so that's one of the top three mistakes I make with my forehand drops. So we definitely want to try to avoid it. For whatever reason with the backhand, I don't really have that problem. I don't think it's as big of an issue. For the forehand, it's a problem. So anyways, some helpful things I was working on today. I hope it helped you. Thank you for your support of the channel. If you haven't yet, please subscribe, like the video. And go check out some of my other videos. And thank you again. Have a great rest of your day. Pickle on, dudes.